Do you remember that experience of getting really excited for a meal? Like when mom would make your favorite food and you know that tonight at supper time you're gonna get that delicious, delicious food? I still get that feeling a lot whenever Father Duane makes some spicy pasta or when I go to someone's house to get tacos, because I love tacos. And then it's that kind of expectant hunger that we see with our readings today during this Advent season. The first reading from the book of Isaiah speaks of the feast of that God will provide on the holy mountain. It says it's a feast of rich, choice foods and so rich foods and choice wines. And it keeps saying like rich, juicy foods and pure choice wines. So it's a very amazing type of feast that the Lord is preparing. And we're meant to see that this isn't just a feast that produces a hunger within us that is just a primal hunger or just something that's going to satisfy our physical needs, but it's something much deeper that the Lord is going to do. It also says that He's going to wipe away the tears from our eyes, that He's going to break down the veil which veils other people, bring unity to the world, so that it's very much something that's going to satisfy all of our needs, all of our hungers, not just the physical ones, but the ones that we hunger for in a spiritual way as well. We all have needs. We all have conditions that we deal with. We all have circumstances which we wish were different. We wish that we're different in some way or another. And we have these hungers within us for wholeness, hungers for peace, hungers for reconciliation that we want to see fulfilled. And during this Advent season, we're called to ask ourselves, what is it that we hunger for? What is it that you hunger for right now? Perhaps it's to hug somebody you haven't gotten to hug for a long time. Or maybe it's to have a celebration, to actually celebrate a joyous event that you haven't been able to celebrate yet with all the people you want to be there. Or maybe it's to have reconciliation with a family member or a friend where there's been a little breakdown in communication. Whatever our needs are, whatever our hungers are, we're called to recognize that Jesus is the fulfillment of every single one of them. He's the fulfillment of all our needs. He's the one who satisfies every hunger with that delicious feast that he brings that's prefigured in the book of Isaiah on the holy mountain, but then is shown forth in all of its reality with Jesus feeding the 5,000 today in the gospel, that he feeds all those people and they're satisfied. So during this Advent season, we're called to inflame our hopes, inflame those desires, those hungers within us that only Jesus can fulfill. Because then when he does come into our lives, and he will soon, he will fulfill those hungers. He's the one who feeds us from the table of the altar with the Eucharist, and he's the one who fulfills every one of our hopes.